Welcome back to our property at Smeaton. There's been quite a bit of activity since we were here last a couple of weeks ago. We've now got a slab, which has actually just been poured today. The guys are still finishing it off, so that's pretty exciting. We are obviously on a bit of a slope here. We didn't want to have too much of a cut and fill. So minimizing the amount of fill means that the footings didn't have to go too deep down to get into that natural ground. So trying to save a bit of cost, not overcomplicate things. And we also rotated the orientation of the slab so it was perpendicular with the contours of the slope. Again, that's minimizing as much as possible the amount of cut and fill required. In terms of the orientation, we're pretty lucky here. The slope is more or less to the north, and we have an amazing view to the north as well. So the slope is around about 20 degrees to the east of solar north. So solar north is what we talk about as being the ideal orientation for a passive solar home, not to be confused with magnetic north. Magnetic north is around about 10 degrees to the east of solar north or grid north. So a house rotated around about 20 degrees to the east or west of solar north is still going to be fine in terms of having good solar gain and having a fixed roof overhang, providing all the shade that you need for that high angle summer sun. So just wanted to show you a couple of features of the slab while it's in this condition. You'll see here along the edge, we've got this XPS foam. It's a rigid foam insulation. It's about 40 mils thick. That's going to give us around about R1.5 insulation around our exposed slab edge. So we will have 100 to 150 mils of slab edge exposed above the ground once all this is finished. So that's obviously a place where you can potentially be losing heat from out of your slab. In addition, that insulation actually goes all the way down to the bottom of the trenches, all the way around the perimeter of the building. So 600 to 800 mils below the ground. That is so that the underside of the slab is not going to be so susceptible to the changing temperature more to the upper surface of the ground around the building. So that's going to give us a bit of a buffer and make the underside of the slab more of a stable temperature. We don't actually have insulation under the slab. I don't think that's going to be necessary, and I think we've saved about $15,000 by not having it. But to collect some data on that, you can see here we've actually embedded a temperature sensor into the concrete. So going into there is a wire with a metal tip on the end, which is a temperature sensor that's embedded around about in the center of the slab, so about 50 millimeters down. And this one here is quite close to the edge of the building and on the south shady side of the slab. So we'll be collecting some temperature data from that to see actually what is the temperature of that slab throughout the year. We also have another one more in the center of the building, which is going to get a bit more sun on it being in the living area. So we can compare the temperatures at two different locations within the building and also be monitoring outside air temperature and inside building temperature just to see how the whole building is functioning without any heating or cooling running. It'll be interesting just to see in real life how that information compares to the data that we get from the energy rating software, so first rate, which gives you a simulation, but we're more interested in the real world functionality, I guess, of a building like this.